Hello, YouTube. It's Misha. I'm out camping this weekend. And right now it's the middle of the night. This camp spot that I'm in, it's not entirely secluded. There's a road nearby, and the cars are really loud. During the day, you could just hear them constantly, which kind of the immersion of being out in the wilderness. But there's also lots of people around, and they do that too. There is, however, no internet connection. I have been using my phone quite a bit, though. I haven't been able to listen to much music. I didn't even notice until I got here, really, that there isn't much music on my phone at all. I don't know if I should try to change that, because I usually just have the internet. So I haven't been able to send any messages and stuff. But I can look back at the ones I've received and it's nice to revisit memories. I've been having lots of ideas too. They're new ideas, but they're more like recombinations of other ones. Some of them are actually, they seem a little threatening to my identity, which is possibly unfortunate, because usually when that happens, generally means that something has to die or be deconstructed. But even thinking about that, I mean, what is identity, right? Except a story, a narrative that is made up of the experiences we've had and the choices that were made within and from those experiences. And no matter what, the narrative isn't going to change just by looking at those things. Like, maybe it can be unreliable at times to really feel like you have a sense of identity, but I mean, because it is just a story, but it's also a story that has a fundamental reality. It's not gonna change. So when my identity does feel threatened by some ideas, I'm not entirely sure what it is I'm even afraid of. I guess that's how fear works a lot of the time, though, right? You're afraid of the unknown. You can be afraid of the unknown even if anything. Even if you cannot imagine any possible risk or negative consequences from something, it can still be one of the most terrifying things. When it comes to the unknown, though, I can't really say that whenever I've reached for the unknown, that it has been a negative experience. I mean, if I were to look at the number ratio of times that the unknown ended up being something good versus bad, the good outweighs the bad by quite a bit. And so that kind of becomes its own conditioning in time. Condition someone into recklessness. I wonder if it could even, like, manifest as an addiction or something. Pursuit of the unknown. in, like, a dangerous way. Really think how that would be dangerous, but perhaps my imagination is limited. Let's see. I've been drawing a few pictures while I've been out here. Let's see if I can. I don't know where they went. I'm looking for my sketchbook, but. Gone that far, there's only so much room in this tent. I can't really see much though. I don't have my contacts in or my glasses. It's a little better. But I still don't see my sketchbook. Oh, there it is. It's far away in the corner. But it's cold over there. I guess I don't want to show you that. I mean, it's not like I'm particularly proud of these pictures, it's just I haven't been able to draw very much lately at all. It's one of those things where, like, I can't tell if it's an artist block or if it's a more permanent problem. I know what an artist block feels like. And this doesn't feel like an artist block. I guess it's not entirely if I can draw a little bit. But I have to rely on certain things in order to draw anything. Most of the stuff I draw, it's like it can't be my own idea. It has to be someone else's idea. And that works for commissions and stuff, obviously, because it's always the client's idea, but if I'm trying to do personal art and I can't because I can't take my own thoughts and represent them, I don't know, maybe that's a type of artist block, maybe it even has a name. Maybe we should come up with a name. If you think of a good one, There's cars driving on the road. I don't know if you can hear them, but to me it seems pretty loud. There's so many people driving at 3 in the morning. Go home. Something with the flashlight here, but it's so dark, I can't see anything. I'm certain this flashlight used to be a lot brighter. It's a headlamp, actually. So you can put your hands free. Possibly the flashlight on my camera would be brighter, but I'm running pretty low on battery. I can hear some sort of animal out there now. We're good for a second. Sort of sounds like a hooting. It could be an owl. You probably can't hear that, but it sounds really cool. I mean, it's just an owl, I guess, but it sounds like in the movies, and it's cool. Maybe there's two of them out there. I can't really. Campground manager told me that there's a moose that comes around here. Just like walks through the camp. Lives around here, I guess. The advice he gave me was just leave it alone, and it'll leave me alone. And I was thinking, yeah. I mean, who would fuck with a moose, right? But I guess there's all sorts of people in the world out there. Once when I wasn't camping, I was staying at a cabin. I was walking around and I got to see a moose with her calf, actually. I ended up accidentally pretty close to them, which probably makes me lucky that they didn't happen to feel threatened. There are some big, scary hoofed mammals in the world. Okay, well, I think I'm gonna try to go back to sleep. Listen to the owls out there and see if they can lull me to sleep. has been a pleasure chatting with you. I'll talk to you later.